Live at the RSA conference here in SF, the focus, cybersecurity, and we set the scene with Kevin Mandia, the CEO of Mandiant, of course, now part of the Google family. Kevin, it's good to see you.
Ed, thanks for having me.
Let's start by saying 2022, a relatively quiet year from a cybersecurity perspective. We recognize that the digital threats...
To you, might have been quiet.
Well, I know you're always very busy.
Right.
But your peers, many of them standing around us now, what is the topic of conversation today? What is the focus?
Well, I think there's a lot of focuses. When you review 2022 and then looking into the future, in 2022, I think the focus was, hey, there was more 0 days than before. We got to get better at the blocking and tackling, the patch management. China really innovated on offense when it came to cyber espionage. We had...
You've gone straight to China, which is interesting because we recognize heightened geopolitical tensions between the United States and China.
Right.
Do we see a ramp up in cyber activity coming from China correlate to that?
Well, I do, you know, my view of all ideological and geopolitical conditions is kind of seen in the cyber domain. What I can opine on is in the cyber domain, I feel we saw more innovation, meaning more vulnerability research and exploitation out of China that to me was innovative, it was creative, and advanced, and we saw them doing better operational security. So in that regard, offensive cyber espionage techniques out of China had perhaps its best, you know, greatest one-year advancement in my 30-year career.
Mandiant, as it's been in the news cycle, has also been focused on activity in North Korea, particularly around ransom. Mm-hmm. We recognize that President Biden hosts his South Korean counterpart in the coming days.
Sure.
How much is that a threat at the moment? It seems somewhat random, the ransom activity that comes out of North
Korea. Well, you know, when you look at ransomware in particular, we saw actually a decrease in the over 1,100 cases where we were hired to investigate what happened and what to do about it. We saw our ransomware investigations actually go down. But when we do threat research or respond to North Korean threat groups, we are seeing them hack to make money. And those intrusions that are usually more indiscriminate, you know, that's kind of like, let's hack who we can and do some mining and things of that nature.
It's basically been a year since Mandiant joined Google Cloud. Mm-hmm. What's that transition been like? You're a founder, CEO, essentially.
Right.
Do you remain entrepreneurial? How do you operate within a big beast like that?
Well, so, you know, first, I don't feel that much of a change. We had tremendous alignment between what Mandiant's vision of, you know, their cybersecurity future was and what Google Cloud's vision for what they want to do in cybersecurity. When you have that kind of alignment, it's kind of like two armies marching in the same direction towards the same goal. So it was easy to come in and integrate. I haven't felt change. We're still responding to breaches that matter. We're still advising customers on the consulting side how to transform your security programs. I think the big change, back to your first question, which was kind of, you know, what was 2022? What are we looking forward to? We are coming up on a shift change in security. You know, cloud was a shift change in security where people had to recognize you could do security from the cloud or you had to do it for the cloud. Now we have AI coming out.
Right.
And it's going to be a shift change. And
you finally took us there.
Absolutely. Yes.
So generative AI, I mean, how does it change defense?
Oh, totally. Yeah. So, you know, the best analogy I have, because the ways that it can do it is probably too quick for a soundbite, is I remember when Tesla one day just updated and my car could drive itself. And
I
remember, absolutely. And I remember going, oh, there's no way it can drive itself. And first day I'm gripping the wheel. Second day I'm on the 280 and I'm like, it worked. I think AI, you're going to see some of the most rapid advances where security challenges that were very hard, like great identity security, suddenly we go, wow, we're great at it now. So you're going to see advancements coming at speeds.
Well, advancements, I mean, how are you integrating Bard very quickly? Because that is where Google has shown its hand.
Well, we're creating, you know, for the security use case, you know, the way I look at it is kind of coming from the other side. So there's Bard coming at you for generative AI, but I'm looking at it from the Vertex point and looking at it from, we need our own models in security so that we can determine anomalies to logons, anomalies for processes. The security use case is going to have different data, different machine learning models. So I kind of look at it from that standpoint, but I can feel the shift change coming. It will be real, and complex challenges are suddenly going to get easier for us.
Yes or no, are you making money for Google?
Am I making money? Yes.
Yes or no, will you be there in a year's time, still part of that bigger company?
Yeah.